Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be walking you through what it is that I have inside of my diaper planning caddy. This is not, of course, a caddy specifically for planner items, but if you guys are part of the planning community, you guys know that I believe in December there was a whole craze about these diaper caddies and how you could store all of your stationery, stickers, and so on and so forth for all your planning needs. I'm not sure who it was that started this trend, but I did see Julie over on Julie's Plans talking about this, and that's kind of when I jumped right into the bandwagon and decided to keep my planning supplies in a diaper caddy as well. So today I'm going to be walking through what it is that I have inside of my diaper caddy. So let's go ahead and get started. Now here you can see a more closer look as to the top view of my diaper caddy. And I'm just gonna go ahead and get started. So I have all of my sticker organization, or for the most part, in this caddy. If you guys are wondering where it is that I keep this caddy as a whole, this stays in my closet. So I don't know if you guys have seen how my room looks. It's very tiny. I do all of my sticker shop things in here, so I don't have that much room. So this does stay inside of my closet. And whenever I'm ready to plan for the week, film a plan with me, anything like that, I'll go ahead and bring it out. The first two little sticker albums that I have here are from Simply Gilded. I have mentioned these time and time again. I love them for storing not only the stickers that I sell in my shop, but also stickers from Simply Gilded. I'm sorry about the glare, by the way. From Simply Gilded, two little bees, and just smaller ones like these from Simply Watercolor Co. So I love, love this small sticker book. And this will usually be on my desk on days like when I film my weekly check-in videos. But since I'm not filming that today, that is going to stay inside here. And then I do have this other book, and if you guys are wondering, I'm really sorry about the glare, by the way, of the ring light. If you guys are wondering, these come in the Simply Gilded subscription boxes. I believe these two were from there. And in this sticker album, I keep all of just random stickers that I have from different shops. I have a bunch of like ombre heart checklists, movie marquees, boxes from various different planning shops. So that's kind of what I house in here. And whenever, let's say, I am planning for the week and I don't have a specific sticker, like maybe a habit tracker, I'll go ahead and go into this album and check out if I have any stickers. I've been collecting stickers for a few years, so that is kind of how I came about having all these stickers, by the way. Don't think that I just, bought them all on a whim. Next, I have this sticker album from Erin Condren, and here I actually have two. One of them is in here. This is where I keep all of my budget stickers that I'll use in my deluxe monthly planner. And then the other one that I have, it's not here because I have it on my desk with the rest of my Erin Condren sticker books. This is how this one looks. I actually made a video all about organizing my Erin Condren stickers. So if that is something that you'd be interested in checking out, I will go ahead and leave a link for that down below. So this just lives up here with my sticker books, which I won't be showing you guys today, of course, because this video is all about my diaper caddy. But let me know if you guys would like to see an office tour video. After that sticker book, I have one of these new Erin Condren Petite Monthly Planners. I typically use these to test out my stickers. I do sell budget stickers in my shop, Romina Rosa. I will go ahead and leave a link for that down below. I just opened up my standalone shop, so if you guys would like to check that out, it's just rominarosa.com. So I also keep this here just in case I want to try out any of my new petite planner stickers. Aside from that, I also have some of these page protectors for some of the stickers that I use in these smaller binders. I did make a video all about this too, organizing my stickers. These are just Russell and Hazel mini binders. I just got the marble one because I thought that it would go perfectly with just anything. In this first one, I just house all of the kits that I'll be using for the next couple of weeks. I have a little sticky note here that I got from a booklet from Erin Condren, and I've organized all of my kits as for the weeks that I'll be using them in. So I have quite a bit in here, as you guys can sort of see there. So that is one of my mini binders. And then the second one houses all of my character stickers, as well as like foiled scripts and icons from SPC. I love these so much. The organization of this was also in that same video, if you guys would like to check that out. So I also do like to have these Avery tabs to kind of let me know when I'm changing shops. So This is where Another Shop starts. This is where Fox and Pip starts, which is one of my favorite sticker shops, Paper Milk, and so on and so forth. So this is how this sticker album looks. Behind that, I do keep some of these colorful dots from Erin Condren. I've loved to use these in my past life planners as well as in my budget planner. So that's kind of where it stays. And then behind that, I keep some of these plastic pouches. These were from Erin Condren. I know a lot of you guys asked me last time I made my Erin Condren sticker organization video as to where you guys could purchase these, but these are no longer available. This is how they look. They just look like a little envelope. Let's say Erin Condren. I have four of them, and in these, I like to house stickers like the ombre boxes, some weekly kits. I definitely want to use that in the future. Then some floral weekly kits, and then these are holiday specific. After these pouches, I have one of these notebooks. The cover just says Romina Rosa 2020. This notebook is from Erin Condren. And in the beginning of the year, I was actually using this to create monthly budgets for my sticker shop. I have now transitioned to a better way of tracking just expenses and income in my business planner, which I have kind of shown, I think in the past, maybe in my business planner setup video. But I still do houses in here. Every now and again, I will go into it and write down ideas that I have. But for the most part, all of that is now in my business planner. But I still do keep it in here just in case I want to reference it or go to it every so often. So that is behind those. And then behind that, and the last thing for this side of the diaper caddy would be my iPad. This is not the new iPad, but it is the iPad Pro. I also have an Apple Pencil in here. I will try to link as many things as I can. If you guys are interested in like the case for this, I really actually love it. And I think it goes really well with all the pink that I have in like my planner and other accessories. So that is what I have in the back. I don't use this as often as I wish I would use it, but I still do like to use it every so often. So that is that side. I didn't mention this in the beginning of the video, but this diaper caddy does have three little slots. The great thing about this diaper caddy also is that you can take this off. So if you just wanted to have one slot instead of having three of these, you can do that. So that's kind of a good thing about this. I also didn't even mention where this is from. I don't think I have the one that everybody else has. This is just one from the brand Tea Home, which once again, if you guys want to check out any of the products, I will try to have links for every single thing that I mention. If I don't have something linked down below, please let me know by commenting, and I will go ahead and put that there for you in the description box. So inside this perfect little spot is my budget planner. This is where I keep it. If you guys are new to my channel or just don't know this, I use the Deluxe Monthly Planner from Erin Condren as my budget planner. This girl is pretty chunky, as you guys can see from using a ton of stickers, which I love. So this is kind of where I house this budget planner, just because I don't use it on a day-to-day basis, but rather on a weekly basis for like weekly check-ins and mostly like in the beginning of the month as well for all of my budgeting videos. So that is what comes in here. And then I also do have these interchangeable covers that I've used in the past for that budget planner. I honestly don't have a rhyme or reason why I keep these in here, but I just really like the cherries once again. That's probably like my favorite print from Erin Condren. Also, really sorry if you guys can hear my little brother playing games in the background. So that is what I have in that little slot. And then the last little slot here, I'm gonna just zoom in just a little bit. This is where I house the rest of my stickers, as well as just other things that I don't have places for or that I haven't used yet. So I wanted to keep in here. The first thing would be one of these little pencil pouches. This was from the Once More With Love collaboration with Michaels. I just thought it was so cute and definitely wanted to support Once More With Love. This is how it looks on the inside. I think I've shown this before too. I also in the front have some of these jumbo paper clips. I've used one of them, so I just decided to leave the other three in here so that it reminds me that I have them and to use them. So that is that. I think I have a bunch. Yeah, I have a bunch of the Once More With Love collab with Michael. So we have some of these cute, not like puffy stickers, but like metal stickers. On the back, I have a ton of photo albums that I bought off of Michaels. They're like, probably like the cheapest thing ever. And this is where I've housed a lot of my stickers. I have since then moved quite a bit of my sticker collection towards these mini binders, but I do still have a couple of stickers in here, so that is what I have here. I have a variety of different ones. Still have like some Fox and Pip stickers. I have even some Once More With Love stickers. And this is where all of my old Planner Kate sampler stickers were at. I haven't really used these in a while, but I just decided to just keep it in here just in case one day I decide to use them. I also have a few of these reusable sticker books. This one specifically is from Once More With Love. This one was from the Michaels collection. Tell me this is not the cutest little thing ever. And then I have my favorite one that I got off of Amazon. It's a pink glitter one, so of course that one has to be my favorite. And in here, I've shown this before, I have a ton of like foiled scripts from SPC, among like other stickers. I think I have like samplers and like some date squares from Rose Color Days. Behind that, I have a ton of sticker books from, once again, the Once More With Love collection. I haven't used these in a while. I think I did use them for like one spread, but haven't really been reaching for these as much as like my other stickers that I have. But once again, just wanted to support her shop because I really love her stuff. And then last but not least, what I have in here would be my Erin Condren Rainbow Accordion Pouch, Zipper Pouch. In here, I keep stickers. I've mentioned this before. I divide all the foil stickers that I have. So in here I have holographic foil, I have silver, gold, pink. I also have in this one all of my Romina Rosa stickers, so stickers from my shop that I don't have like a space for. And in here I think I have holiday specific stickers. So I really have been liking this. I've always mentioned how I think this was such an innovative idea to do, and I do use it, and it fits perfectly in this spot with the rest of my stickers. Last but not least, I didn't even mention what I had in these pockets. In here I don't house too many things. I have two pins in here. One is from SPC and the other one is from the Erin Condren LA store, so I went ahead and just put them in here. I also have some of these sticky corner pockets that I purchased from the last warehouse sale. Inside here I don't have anything else, and they fit perfectly in here, so that's where I keep them. In here I think I have like an old key from my budget planner, and some, there's just a few here, some of these sticky notes from Erin Condren, which I love. And then last but not least, I just have this little pink bow notepad from one of the Simply Gilded subscription boxes. So I think that is all. Yeah, I don't have anything in the back because this honestly faces the wall when I put it in my closet, so I don't really need to have anything. But there is quite a bit of space to put other things like pens and stuff like that. I just don't put those in here because I have like two pen holders over on my desk. So that is pretty much going to be it for this video. I would like to thank my patron Stephanie because she was the one that gave me this video request. She also actually asked for a what's in my bag video, but I honestly haven't been going anywhere, so I didn't think that that was really appropriate for right now. But thank you so much, Stephanie, for this video request. And if you have any other video requests that you would like to see here on my channel, let me know by commenting down below. Please don't forget to give this video a huge thumbs up, as well as subscribe to my channel if you guys are not subscribed already. And hopefully I will get to see you guys on my next video. Bye guys!